Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Chairman Corker, Ranking Member Cardin, and distinguished members of the committee, thank you for the opportunity to testify today regarding State Department authorization. As Secretary Kerry has said, American leadership is not just a button that we push in time of emergency. We must be backed by resources and authorities. So we're committed to working with the committee on a bill that provides a strong foundation for the State Department and enhances our efforts to be more effective and efficient. Today, I will highlight a few of the authorities that we believe are critically important. And I want to thank members of the committee for your partnership on several of these issues. They include permanent authority to contract local guards with the best value firms to better protect our people and infrastructure, administrative subpoena authority for the Bureau of Diplomatic Security to enhance their efforts to counter passport and visa fraud, permanent authorities to provide greater flexibility to set fees for border crossing, fraud prevention and detection, and passport and visa surcharges, which would support our execution of consular services, authorities to pay our UNESCO contribution, as well as to pay our United Nations peacekeeping dues at the assessed rate, which would help us avoid accruing arrears and enable our continued leadership, and overseas comparability pay authority to better support and retain our workforce by leveling the playing field for overseas pay. The committee has also indicated its interest in hearing from the department on other issues, which I will briefly address now and look forward to discussing further. First, the international community relies on United Nations peacekeeping missions to advance our collective global security. The State Department is committed to UN reform, and we are working to ensure other countries pay their fair share of UN budgets, especially larger developing countries like China, which is now the second largest peacekeeping cost contributor. We recognize the value of peacekeeping missions, but we are appalled by continuing allegations of sexual exploitation and abuse by peacekeepers. The United States has been a driving force behind the UN's zero tolerance policy and will continue to push the UN to bring an end to abuses and hold perpetrators accountable. We are directly pressing troop and police contributing countries named for the first time in last week's United Nations report to promptly and credibly investigate allegations of sexual exploitation and abuse, and where appropriate, to prosecute offenders. Second, the United States faces not only risks to our physical security, but also risks to the security of our information. Since the breach of our unclassified email system in 2014, we have aggressively worked to enhance our cybersecurity. We have strengthened the way our users access the systems, the security testing of our networks and applications, and the training of our staff on the threats that we face. Third, responding to Freedom of Information Act requests is an important element of our transparency efforts. And while the volume of FOIA requests to the department has increased by 300% since 2008, our resources to address them have not kept pace. That's why we have requested a 77% increase in this year's budget for FOIA. And in addition, Secretary Kerry has appointed a transparency coordinator who is spearheading the department's efforts to improve its systems and processes. And finally, our work to advance American leadership and diplomacy around the world is only as strong as our people. To ensure we have the right people in the right places at the right time, we are adopting policies and tools to support our workforce, enhance leadership at all levels, and expand innovation. Mr. Chairman, as discussed in more detail in my written testimony for the record, a strong State Department authorization bill will put the department on a robust footing as we pursue security and prosperity for the American people. I look forward to working with you on this important endeavor. Thank you, and I'm happy to answer questions.